This is a production of PBS 39.
Since winter has finally set into eastern Pennsylvania and western New Jersey, we've decided to give you some reasons to stay home and curl up with a good book. We have a great author joining us right now, Dr. Larry Levitt, who has practiced neurology for more than 30 years, been successful at writing a textbook on neurology, one of the most successful books out there in that field. But now you and your colleague, Dr. John Castaldo, have written The Man with the Iron Tattoo and Other True Tales of Uncommon Wisdom. Dr. Levitt, we appreciate your time. Why this book and why now?
Well, briefly, John Castaldo, a very close friend and colleague, and I spent 20 years together sharing the same desk in our office. John got into the habit from Dartmouth of writing down what he had learned from each patient that he saw. I picked up that habit, but in addition to learning neurological information, we realized that we were learning life information. Information about love, faith, and healing, and what our patients had taught us. And we decided about 5 years ago to write this up and then see if anyone else might be interested in reading about it.
17 different chapters, 17 different profiles?
Actually, 13 chapters. There were 7 of John's and 6 of mine.
Tell us about who is the man with the iron tattoo?
Well, that is one of the 13 chapters and a very intriguing case, and I think an intriguing title, because people always want to know who had the tattoo. It relates to a gentleman who was admitted confused, who had been in the Poconos, came in confused from a concussion, and John wanted to get an MRI. So he started sending the patient for the MRI when the patient said something like, "Doc, you can't do an MRI on me. You're going to kill me." And John leaned forward, "What do you mean I'm going to kill you?" He said, "Well, I have these tattoos, and they have iron in them, and they told me that if I ever had an MRI, I would burn up and die." Well, John had never heard such a thing. We had done tattooed patients for years, checked with the MRI people, and they'd never heard of it either. So he said, "Give him some Valium." So they gave him some Valium, and he went up to his office while the patient was being studied, put in tattoo and MRI, and sure enough came an article from the German literature that said if you have enough iron in the tattoo, having been done as a habit in Persia, Iran, you can get a third degree burn and die. So we charged down to the MRI venture and saved the fellow's life by a split second.
And listening.
And listening
to the patient.
That's correct.
Is a difficult thing. How can patients, what can they do today? Some life examples of what they can do to help their physicians listen to them and take them seriously, because sometimes they're even afraid to say things because they feel like, you know best, I don't want to share. If you don't know about it, then I certainly shouldn't share it.
Well, that's a challenge, especially in today's medical world where the doctor is given 12 minutes by the HMO to spend with the patient. But I think one of the things that patients can do is to write down on a piece of paper or a 3x5 card the questions that they would like to ask of their doctor and expect that that, in fact, will be honored. And I think there are many doctors who will, most doctors, I think, who will listen to their patients. What we learned is that we were not listening well enough to our patients, and we tried to get better and better at that while we were in practice, and John is still in practice, actually is chief of the division at Lehigh Valley Hospital.
I want to share another chapter, Listen to Eva. That one's yours. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, Eva Levitt is my wife, and she's a very special person for those of you who know her. And Listen to Eva is a chapter of 3 examples where listening to Eva was critical. One involved our son Mark, who at the age of about 8 or 9 was going on a fishing trip with me. And he didn't feel well during the night, having had some abdominal pain. And when the person came to pick us both up to fly to Canada into the bush where we'd be incommunicado for 3 days, Mark said he didn't feel well. And I said, "Mark, you're just nervous." And that's what our friend Milton Sheftel said. Eva said, "He's not going." I said, "What do you mean he's not going? We've thought about this for years." She said, "He's not going." Well, we listened to Eva, and to make a long story short, when we got to Montreal, we called home. He wasn't home. I called my in-laws. "Oh, Mark just got out of the operating room. He just had his appendix removed by Dr. George Hartzell, who, by the way, is still in Allentown. And had that not happened, had we not listened to Eva, Mark would not be the pediatric surgeon he is today in Cincinnati. He would not be here."
Dr. Levitt, the book is fantastic. So many great reads, easy reads, warm, heart-touching stories. We want to encourage everyone to read The Man with the Iron Tattoo and Other True Tales of Uncommon Wisdom. Thank you so much, Dr. Levitt, for sharing this with us.
Thank you for having us.